we were sending messages. I sent you a message as soon as I heard. There we go. BuzzFeed is closing down its British and Australian operations. Now, there are some really good people that work for BuzzFeed.
Yeah.
And I hope they go on to find a job somewhere better. There's a lot of absolute clickbait whoremongers that work for BuzzFeed, and I hope they have to go and learn to code. I really do.
I prefer destitution. Motherfuckers. Here's the thing, though. I've defended BuzzFeed in the past. Some of their reporting has been okay, considering the sort of the whole far left slant and all the sort of culture war nonsense that they do involve themselves in. There's been some, I know from doing the Sunday show, when Antifa have rioted and a lot of the papers have just described them as counter-protesters and sort of generically said, you know, there was violence at a Trump rally. When in fact the violence came from Antifa who turned up. Sometimes BuzzFeed has been the only sort of mainstream outlet that has actually honestly reported on it. And it always knocks me. Like,
in the same way that Hitler made sure the trains ran on time.
Yeah.
BuzzFeed was a shitbait fucking organization. I can't wait for them to vanish up their own fucking ass. Maybe they've done this so they can marshal their resources and concentrate more fully on being woke without being broke and having more clickbait, having, you know, embracing cancel culture that little bit more closely, and then run a few more quizzes, because apparently that's what people want from BuzzFeed, quizzes.
Yeah, they can go back to the quizzes, man.
Mark DeStefano's had to leave the Times, hasn't he? What a shame. Was it the Telegraph or the Times? It was the Times, wasn't it?
No, it was the FT, Financial Times. Yeah. But he was going to go back to Australia, apparently. I really hope, I'm praying that BuzzFeed Australia was in his sights and he was just going to quietly, you know, maybe under another name or something. Because that man is such an astonishing scumbag that I hope that was his plan. And just as he was getting close to it, it just drifted away into dust around his evil fingers. Stuff.
The mainstream media detested the internet, embraced social media. The mainstream media is in a terrible... I was talking to a journalist just the other day who's reasonably safe because he operates in a niche sort of market. But the industry's collapsing.
Yes, it
because
is.
Because they disdain the internet. They hate the internet in the mainstream media, but they loved social media because they thought it was free clicks. And then that went away and they're failing. And then all these shitbait sites... Like, Vice used to be really fucking good.
Tim Pool, they started the Vice News, didn't they? And it was
Vice,
fucking amazing.
Vice was amazing. They had camera crews. They went after news. Just went full-blown fucking woke and bullshit. And we're hopefully watching them collapse. We've got Google, who really, really, really upset some people. Because apparently it's now a white supremacist organization because they've dropped most of the diversity programs, including a program, I've forgotten the name of it now, but it was one particular program that trained white people how to talk to people of color and things of this situation.
Because that's what you need, don't you? It's funny, though, isn't it? Because I remember one of the biggest successes of Google's diversity program was the unequal pay study they did. They did a massive thing all across Google, and they found that it was actually the poor white men who were being paid less, and it was more men had pay rises than women. So the whole thing backfired. So maybe it is probably best they just put it to bed, isn't it? I mean, I totally agree, man. I think identifying barriers and reducing those barriers is a great thing to do, but actively searching out people based on certain skin colors, sexes, sexual orientations or whatever.
But the best part,
horrific. Go on.
Google said they were just going to outsource it because they could not. They said, we cannot find a way of making this work. We're going to outsource it to companies that do this. People are still losing their shit. Because some completely dreadful prick whose job it was to be like diversity officer. It's not a job. It's a nothing. It's a meaningless extension of HR to fucking destroy people's fucking lives and bore you to fucking death. But they said, well, they're appeasing conservatives because Google didn't want to be seen as anti-conservative. Well, a bit fucking late for that, isn't it?
It's, you know why? Because there's fucking massive lawsuits against Google right now because they do target conservatives and push them out. I mean, that what about that fella, you know, the memo guy who got kicked out? He wasn't a conservative. His name's totally gone off my head right now, but you know,
Canotta's got a point here.
Go on.
Everything good goes to shit when you have to appease advertisers. This, to a degree, is absolutely true. It's the advertisers that are usually being pressured by pressure groups. To be, if I'm going to play devil's advocate, but that is true because you get rule creep and things that I fucking detest, and you take terrible measures to deal with it. 100% true. But you can kind of go along and say, all right, I get it. You know, I don't like it, but okay. It's the ones that went out of their way before any problems to embrace cancel culture. And BuzzFeed did hugely. And wallow in having other people's financial lives ruined, demonetized, kicked off you. All they wallowed it. They loved it. They reveled in it. Still fucking gone broke. Because that shit will always bite you in the fucking ass. Because once advertisers start getting a bit fucking skirty, ad rates drop. End off.
I think the issue as well, if you go into, if you look at studies of the demographics of social media, so look at Twitter and who follows who and who listens to who, obviously there's a big conservative sphere, there's a big sort of leftist sphere, and there's smaller circles within that. So MAGA Twitter is massive, but you might not realize it because you might be in, you know, rebellion Twitter or whatever the fuck they're calling themselves these days. But the advertisers and the people who produce adverts and do that, they tend to be in the same Twitter bubble as the journalists, as the activists. So to them, representing a woman as somebody who might enjoy taking care of a family, they're going to make a lot of noise about that. And it's going to seem really, it's going to seem a lot more amplified. It's going to be a lot more amplified than it actually is to them because they're all in the same bubble on Twitter, basically. And they all fucking live on Twitter.
But also then it leaks out. And it's very simplistic to say appease advertisers. I don't want to go too deeply into this side of things because it will be in my book.
Are you going to be one of them? Start doing interviews with it behind you there. On the table, whatever.
My entire bookcase will just be filled. It's going to cost me a fortune to get Amazon to print them all for me. Nothing exists in a vacuum. If you have a website of any size, you are completely reliant on advertising or donations. Both are very dangerous positions to be in, believe me. And when the internet changes, what do? Do you let it go? Do you just walk away on your principles? I might. Not everybody else wants to. Other people rely on it for various reasons. So what do you do? You adapt to your environment. And you take all the shit without everybody else seeing where that shit should be spread around properly, including some of the people that give you shit because they help cause it. But, you know, the whole internet has changed so dramatically.
In
the last 10 years. I mean, before that, but the last 10 years, it's been terrifying how it's changed.
It's money though, isn't it? As soon as money was there and influence, you know, the two things hand in hand. Once they started saying, oh, you know, the Facebook had a 3% effect on people's attitude this election. But then once it's getting, nobody cared about the 3%, but then it was growing where it was like Facebook swung this election, you know, then that's when all eyes went on and all propaganda and everything, and it just became insane. I got to say, though, referencing changes on the internet and adapting, we were demonetized on the YouTube. So we are on Twitch now, just to let everyone